ఎవ్రీథింగ్ ఇన్ స్పోర్ట్స్. యూరో 2020 ప్రతి ఒక్క మ్యాచ్ గురించి కూడా మనం మాట్లాడుకుంటూనే ఉన్నాం. ఒక కంప్లీట్ రౌండ్ అప్ ఇవ్వడానికి అండ్ ఫైనల్స్ గురించి మనతో మాట్లాడడానికి ఇండియాని రిప్రజెంట్ చేసి ఫుట్బాల్ ఆడారు అండ్ అలాగే మన ఏటీకే కూడా ఆడిన సందర్భాలు కూడా ఉన్నాయి, గెలిచిన సందర్భం కూడా ఉంది. మోహన్ రాజ్ నల్లపన్ మనతో ఉన్నారు, ఆయనతో మాట్లాడారు. మోహన్ రాజ్ థ్యాంక్ యూ సో మచ్ ఫర్ డూయింగ్ దిస్.
థ్యాంక్ యూ సో మచ్ ఫర్ ఇన్వైటింగ్ మీ.
సో యూరో 2020 వన్ ఆఫ్ ది నైసెస్ట్ ఫ్రెండ్షిప్స్ దట్ హావ్ గాట్ ఇస్ మోహన్ రాజ్ అన్న. ఎవ్రీ మ్యాచ్ ముందు డిస్కస్ చేసుకుని ఏం జరుగుతుంది ఏం చెప్పాలని మాట్లాడుకుంటూ. సో అన్న, ఓవరాల్ గా ఇఫ్ యూ లుక్ ఎట్ దిస్ టోర్నమెంట్, one moment that will stand for you?
Really, it's very hard to say one particular moment, but in terms of Denmark's run, which touched me mostly, right, because it's not only me, right, around the world everybody, yes, supported the Denmark,
right,
because what's happened with them, that first match with Eriksen, so after that they lost against Belgium, then, yeah, again that's last one match against Russia they win, and then they make it into semi-final, and right, even in semi-final the way, yes, they went out, yes, because there was a controversial penalty,
right. Right.
So throughout the tournament their run was really really amazing
and emotional,
and emotional as well, and the world, everybody were behind Denmark, right, because of that one particular incident, right. So that was really really great, right, because to be honest, you being a player in that dressing room, correct, and you being a coach for that team, motivating them after such incident, yes, in the very first day of the tournament that is happening even in the
their home country,
yeah. So it's a really really challenging, and they, how they came out of that challenging situation, which like makes me, as a student of the game, I learned so much from,
yes, absolutely,
journey and that situation.
Absolutely, kudos to every Denmark footballer and also the coach Kasper Human,
yeah,
yeah. But again, you have mentioned it, Gabate, I'm asking you that penalty.
Yeah.
What do you have to say? Is it harsh? Is it not a penalty? Or it can be given, could not be given? As a footballer, as a person who has have some coaching knowledge?
See, to be honest, if it is penalty or not, if you ask me, I will say that no. But the problem is that every human can make mistakes.
Correct.
Like even referee made mistakes. If you see throughout the major tournaments, England, the decade ago when Lampard scored in World,
right,
Cup,
right,
and it's gone inside of the goal line and it's came out, but it was like cancelled goal. As a nation, even they gone through such way,
correct,
previously.
Correct.
So, somehow, some sort of like, you know,
lovely,
let's say they suffered previously, and today
lovely,
they are end up in a favored position.
Right.
But my only concern about all these things, I am not going to blame referee. He's human, he can make mistake. But those days were not goal line technology, no,
right,
war,
right,
but war cannot make mistakes.
War cannot make mistakes. But again, see, war pati is a, because referee has already given it as a penalty.
Yeah.
You know, war has only...
No, that's how it's cancelled in many,
correct,
like, you know, Premier League, and also,
correct,
after scoring goal in Champions League, Manchester City,
correct,
scored against Tottenham,
correct,
after celebration they stopped,
yes, stop,
and then it's not goal.
Not
so goal. That's where they kept the war, because if you are making wrong decision, if you made the decision and you allowed that it's a penalty, then you are going to check in the war. If it is no, then you must stop and you must correct the referee that you
but
made a mistake,
okay,
but it was not happened. So which was, for me, could not digest.
Correct.
Penalty, no, but referee can make mistake, he is human, and England take advantage of that situation, because previous years they suffered, but today it's end up with favor for them.
Right.
But war is questionable thing for me.
Again, that question is similar, no, na? Suppose the referee has allowed it as penalty. The only thing war can say is whether contact happened or not, once the referee asks them what has happened, but there was a little contact there.
But
so
that's too soft. It's too soft to give a penalty in extra time, and that goal can decide one will go out of the semi-final. So if it is a too soft or like 50-50 chance, we must say no, which,
yeah,
the game is still alive and game is open. The remaining minutes they fight and then end up in tiebreaker, yeah, they can decide the game, whatever it is. But
yeah,
that one goal killed the journey.
Chances. And before that also, there was one challenge on Harry Kane, which was not allowed the penalty, because the referee's discretion,
yeah,
was ball and Harry Kane, both impact was at once, and there was,
yeah,
also another ball coming into picture and all of those things.
Yeah, the before that Harry Kane incident, that before that move, the Poulsen, I think,
right,
Harry Kane went run, that he fouled Poulsen and went inside,
right,
but went inside, it was 100% penalty for,
right,
me at that,
okay,
particular moment.
Right.
But referee stopped the game, that previous move, it was fouled. But then again, the previous move, it is 100% foul if you ask me, then it's like soft, 50-50. So it's like somewhere he balanced the situation.
He
just stopped there and he allowed here. According,
right,
to me, I might be wrong,
right,
but that's how I look at in that situation.
Right, superb batman. Again, if you have a word about the goalkeepers, everybody has done well. A lot of penalties were saved, but ungalku one goalkeeper has stood out for you, Ram. Who is that person?
So it's really, really very hard to pick one goalkeeper. If you ask me, I would like to prefer Switzerland goalkeeper Sommer. And absolutely, it was fabulous. And Denmark keeper Schmeichel.
Yes.
So these two goalkeepers were really, really amazing. You know, so tiebreaker lo kuda vandute. So in tiebreaker also Switzerland goalkeeper saved 2 minutes, but their player could not convert it. Throughout the game, he kept the team alive. Even tiebreakers, he kept
them
alive.
Because of him, they went to the quarters.
So Sommer and Schmeichel
also has done really well. Denmark. Save almost 8 saves in
that match against England. So these two goalkeepers, for me, they are standout keepers according to me till today, sir. But Donnarumma also one of my favorite Italian keeper.
మోహన్ రాజ్ అనకి ప్రిడిక్షన్స్ చేయడం చాలా బాగా వచ్చు అన్నమాట. అంటే ఈ టీం గెలుస్తుందంటే గన్ షాట్ ఆ టీం గెలుస్తుంది. ఆల్ యువర్ ప్రిడిక్షన్స్ కేమ్ రైట్ రైట్ ఫ్రమ్ ది రౌండ్ ఆఫ్ 16 టు క్వార్టర్ ఫైనల్. ఇది ఎప్పుడు హౌ ఇస్ దట్ పాసిబుల్?
నో, ఇట్స్ నాట్ అబౌట్ పాస్, ఇట్స్ నాట్ ఎవ్రీబడి క్యాన్ లైక్ యు నో ప్రిడిక్ట్, బట్ దే వే ఐ ప్రిడిక్టెడ్ టు బి ఆనెస్ట్, లైక్ యు నో ఇఫ్ సంబడి ఇస్ గోయింగ్ టు ప్లే టుమారో, సో జస్ట్ ఐ సిట్ డౌన్ నైట్ లైక్ యు నో, సో సిన్స్ ఐ స్టడీడ్ ఫర్ అ కోచ్ లైక్ ఐ జస్ట్ గోయింగ్ టు పిక్ అప్ వన్ టీమ్. So I am going to coach this team. For small example, so to final is Italy and England. So I will react like, okay, I am going to be Italy coach and I am going to play match against England. So what they are doing, what's their strength, weakness. So what I have strength, weakness, what formation they are playing and what formation I can put to counter and attack that formation. So I just try to do for like 3-4 hours in writing in papers, making formation, picking up the players, all these things. Then I will come to analyze each part defensively, mid third and attacking third and wing and the goalkeepers. Overall, I try to mix everything, put it into my mind. Then I come into one conclusion that I believe that, yeah, this team is going to win because of this. Then I put up, again, I will next day when I see the coaches, the formation and the players, that almost 80 to 90% the same happened. So somehow it's good learning experience in this tournament as a coaching point of view at the commentator, so I can give my valuable prediction.
Tomorrow's prediction, England will play back 4 or back 5?
No, that's a really, really confusing topic still. Correct. So far what I was, but if you see overall team, I will say that Italy is far better than England according to me. If you ask me why, England also reached finals, but if you see the way, amount of goals England scored, that only match they scored 4 goals.
Ukraine.
During that matches also they conceded in set pieces.
Yes.
And they went to sleep, second half starting they went to sleep, first half starting went to sleep, they scored goals just like that. Apart from that, if you see Sterling, almost the smallest player, and then he's scoring in the heading because opposition's organization was not good, so they punished that. But if you ask me, they are not really played beautifully and made any goal. And especially, you are not even done that throughout the tournament. And you to do that thing against Italy, it's going to be really, really tough. Italy are the team, they are not even almost 12 games, only 2 goals they concede. And 32 games or 33 games, they never lost. Yeah. So, they are really, really good in defensively. And that Italy team can play with ball, they can keep ball position. And without ball, they can defend full one day also.
Yeah, full one day with without ball.
And if they want to if they want to high press also, they can high press. And they are good in counter attack also.
Right.
They are good in aerial balls also. So if you see overall, the complete package. And in middle, they can dominate. They have a ball players, Verratti, Jorginho, Barilla. So if you see England's midfielder, Phillips and Rice, they can really defend, but their contribution in attacking is not compared to these people's. So middle of the pitch also, this team can really control. And defensively, yeah, really they can control. But the only thing is that if Italy is trying to play any aerial balls to using heading for Immobile, then they will fail. Right. Because that's where England is so strong. Maguire and Stones. And these players are really, really strong. So when it comes to attacking third for Italy, still they are little bit superior England, but overall if you see, Italy is far better than England.
Will England go with the same formation as like the Germany? Because there is a chance that they still
that formation should have they done it against Denmark.
Okay.
And if you recollect your memory that Trippier came in, then you see the dynamic change and they started keeping the ball possession for almost 3 to 4 minutes without giving away.
Trippier was a
4-3-3 formation. I don't think so. He will go for a five-man defending. Man. No, I don't think so. But 4-2-3-1 will be the expected formation. But they will be 4-3-3. But the best part with Italy is that anytime they can change
to 4-2-5-3-2.
While playing, they play two formations. Like they start up with 4-3-3. Then if you see that five-man, like three center backs, then two wide wing backs like that.
Right.
So it's according to that. It's the beauty of the game, how the coaches battle. Like, you know, if you try to change your formation, then they will change one player, then they'll according to that they fix. So that's the beauty.
You have played football, highest forms of football you have played, you have seen crowd cheering for the people. How will it be, you know, for example, Italy is not playing in their home conditions and people are getting behind Indian team, for example. So how is that crowd pressure and crowd energy that will get into you?
Yeah, exactly. This is the very, very interesting question. To be honest, so that's why they are professionals. They've been playing under the big crowd atmosphere. But when it comes to finals in England, Wembley, but it's more under-pressing situation for England because they never been into finals. They assured that they are in under pressure to win it in their home ground. So the expectations are so high. Italy is just being away from home. Then again, when it comes to this thing, crowd thing, so that's where the experience matters. If you calculate the squad age limit, and if you see England's age, average age limit is like almost mid-20s, something like that. And then if you see that Italian squad, they are like almost 29-30 is the experience and they are very mature. That finalists, it's all about emotional involved game. It's who have big hearts.
Well,
it's
not a,
who have nerves and big hearts, they can sustain and they can go up. So when it comes to this point of view, and it reflects coach who you are.
Right.
That you present your team on that particular day. In terms of coaches here, Southgate, he done very good job with young players, but he never tasted any success.
Right.
But when it comes to Mancini, he's been tested so many teams, he transformed into a successful team and he know how to do it, that he won major tournaments like with Manchester City, they've been not winning 40 or something years trophy and he made that team and he won.
Right.
So Italy, they were not even qualified for World Cup and he just took that team to 33 or 34 matches unbeaten. So when it comes to that personality, individually as a coach, Southgate and Mancini, still Mancini is far better than Southgate, according to me, but still he done a great job, Southgate, with young players in England team, but players and coach, they never seen that success and that final match atmosphere that knows.
Right.
So Mancini is far better and the players are very experienced with age, so I guess this will be the little bit upper hand for Italy.
Right, so Monadana, for you, the cup is going to Rome, not home.
Yeah. It's going wrong.
So let us see, man. Sudhir Gar matra home and enter.
But I am a pure English Premier League lover, and I've been supporting so long England. And whenever I put up also who will win, then I will say that my mind says Italy, my heart wants England. But if I am as an expert, I am as a football. So why I am supporting Italy? So I told you
these are
the things I take into consideration. So I believe Italy will win. But at the end of the day, football surprises everyone. And that particular day, if they don't present themselves what they used to present.
But Italy did struggle at Wembley. It was not an easy
game. Yeah, obviously. Because first two games against Austria and Spain, they suffered in that Wembley stadium.
So let us see what's going to happen. Sudhir Garu Matram Kachitang England Antaru. A video in Twitter la bitta and dance is in video. Chudachu. So thank you so much, Mona Janna, for your time and for all the tips regarding commentary and also football.
Most
thank you so much.
Thanks a lot.